for some reason they're not, they don't know what they're going to have available in 3 months or so, you can at least get the website so that that part of your research is done. So just keep everything organized. So come May, you can just go in and see what you like or didn't like and apply for it. But some companies like XTO won't know what we have available until May, but at least we can give you the website where to apply once you're ready to go for it.
Well, like for our company, by the time you get through our interview process, by the time you get through the contracting and licensing process, by the time you acquire your license, by the time you do all of this stuff, okay, you're going to be graduating. So, I mean, for us, like specifically, I think it depends on a lot of what company you're dealing with. That's why it's important to say, I'm graduating in May, and just kind of laying that out there. And so I'd be able to tell you that, hey, this is what we have available. Our internship, we have one of the top 10 internship programs in the nation. We've been rated that way for 16 consecutive years. And we have a special one for newly graduating seniors that leads straight into a full-time career. So, and there could be a chance for you to even kind of get started in some type of part of an internship until you get there or get there later. So I think it's just very company specific, so just laying that out there for them. And they'll be able to answer that question.
I would say do your research, because the companies are going to be all over the world. So we just completed our interview, our hiring process for May graduates for our national sales program. But we have other positions that come up kind of every quarter in our Plano, at our Plano site. But we're positioning, for the next. So you're going to find everything, but really get in there and do. So I'll start, and some of us are. It really, I would say, know your industry. It does vary, and anything in excess is exactly that, right? Too much is too much. Too much of a good thing is still too much, right? So just too much is too much. Too high of a heel is too high of a heel. Too many earrings. So if you for 1 second when you're getting dressed to leave question it, I wouldn't do it. Because there's some inner gut that's saying, yeah, maybe this is too much. So just watch, just take it, just remove, right? You don't, just take it out of the mix of the whole, and then you don't have to go, oh, what if I, maybe it's because I didn't have, because I wore that eighth earring, around my, whatever, I shouldn't have, whatever. There's all kinds of crazy stuff. But there's a lot of things that go on now that I can play for as well. When you cut dead in pants, So I just, too much is too much, and trust your gut, and then you gotta be yourself too. So don't, if that's what you're gonna wear to work every day, regardless, then think about what industry you wanna do as well, right?
I think again, going back to the industry, if you were to walk in to me when I was a public relations coordinator for an advertising marketing agency, and you were dressed a bit more trendy, because you were young, get trendy onto the scene, advertising firm. I'm not going to look at you the same as now. And you always dress for the job that you want. And there's no such thing as overdressing. It's just like kind of when you're getting ready to go out to go to a wedding or something like that. And so you could always ask, after maybe you get the interview, say, I actually have a nose that I was wondering if that would be appropriate to wear in the office or not. I've obviously removed it. Or, once you get to that point where you feel like you know where you're at or you know you're in, you can ask about that kind of stuff later, but again, in our industry, you want people to give you money. You want to help them prepare a financial plan. If somebody is all tatted up with their hair all purple and everywhere, do you really want to give them money? Probably not, So, just kind of, again, thinking about where you're going and just being ready. I can't wear, it's a huge shame for me, I can't wear probably 3/4 of my wardrobe to work. And I look like I'm in high school. I, at the grocery store last night, a 16-year-old thought I was in high school. I'm like, too old for this. So, it's like, I always have to dress in a suit and, go out and be prepared whenever I'm at any type of presentation. I always suit up. So, it's just thinking about stuff like that when I'm in school.
You all look great dressed up, right? So, take advantage of it. Everybody looks better when they kind of get beat up, right? So, don't underestimate the power of that from a marketing or self-standpoint.